I'm not getting nothing to pimp me. I believe what I speak. And if you need proof, just keep watching. Turn your Bibles to 1 John chapter 4, verse number 18. 1 John chapter 4, verse number 18. I pray for your man of God's strength. I am just so amazed at how good God is.
Yes, sir.
1 John chapter 4, and while you're looking for it, this week the cousin of NBA superstar Dwayne Wade was shot and killed in Chicago while pushing her baby down the street in a stroller. And to no one's surprise, Donald Trump used this senseless act of violence as a reason why black people should vote for him in November. Of course, the murder of Dwayne Wade's cousin made national headlines. But unfortunately, this week in Fifth Ward, someone's cousin was also murdered, along with cousins across every inner city community in America. But we must understand, no matter who we vote for in November, and we must vote, no matter who we vote for in November to live in the White House for the next 4 years, if we don't solve the love crises in our community, nothing is going to get better.
That's right.
Matter of fact, I hate to bust your bubble, but regardless if it is Hillary or Trump, if we don't solve the love crisis, things would not get better, but worse.
Yeah, right.
I believe, before we get to the text, remain standing, I believe love is a force strong enough to change the world and save the world at the same time. See, love can fix a dysfunctional family. Love can fix a dysfunctional school system. Love can fix a dysfunctional church. And love can fix a dysfunctional community. See, it's hard. It's hard to rob and to kill when you're being led by love. I'm actually continuing to stand. You're standing now for the families who have been victimized. You're standing for those who are operating in a spirit of hate. See, love weakens the grip of racism, sexism, classism, and any other negative force aimed at keeping us apart. Love forces us, turn to your name and say, love forces us to recognize we are better together, than we are divided.
Love trumps hate.
Now you're ready for the reading of God's word in 1 John chapter 4. We'll begin with verse number 18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear. Because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. Whoever claims to love God yet hates his brother or sister is a liar. For whoever does not love his brother and sister whom he has seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. Take your seat. And let's have our final conversation. Love trumps hate.
Right.
See, fear is one of the most powerful negative emotions that a man can possess. The devil desires to have us living in constant fear because fear will, one, cancel our faith, and secondly, fear will rob us of our confidence. And the devil wants you walking around lacking faith, walking through wild with no confidence, because if he steals your faith and robs you of your confidence, you will not turn to God. You will not trust God. There's no way that family can deal with what they're dealing with if their faith and confidence in God blood had been interrupted, and the devil desires to mess with you and keep you in a situation where you're walking around in fear, where you don't have a personal relationship with God. The devil desires to keep you alive, but keep you separated from God. That's why the devil was so satisfied in the Garden of Eden, because he got Adam and Eve separated from God. He calls Adam and Eve to turn their backs and lose their faith and confidence in going before the throne of grace. And the devil desires to keep you in a situation where you are in so much fear, you feel like that God can't answer your prayers because you messed up too bad. The devil will make you feel like there's no connection with God, so he messes with your faith and messes with your confidence. But the Bible, which is my final authority, the Bible says there is no fear in love.
Come on, man of God.
Fear and worry are the dark rooms in which negative emotions are developed.
That's right.
Hate is a negative feeling.
Amen.
And hate is birthed out of fear.
Amen.
We often fear what we don't understand, and if that fear goes unchecked, it grows into hate. Most of the people you're walking around claiming you hate, you really don't hate them. You really don't understand them. You have no relationship with them. They're different than you. They worship a different way. They speak a different way. They live a different way. So you have allowed the fear of the unknown to have you walking around talking about, I hate white people, or I hate black people, or I hate gay people, or I hate non-Christians. You really don't hate them. You just don't understand the things about them, and your lack of understanding has caused you to go into the dark room. And when you went to the dark room, it birthed a bunch of negative emotions, and those negative emotions unchecked caused you to start declaring you hate people. But you got to realize, if you're hating people, you can't be loving God, because God said if you can't love your brother and your sister, if you can't love your brother and your sister, you can't love me. You can go to church all you want to. You can sing in the choir. You can preach in the pulpit. You can serve on the deacon ministry. You can be a greeter, usher, or a parking lot attendant. But if you don't love your sister, and if you don't love your brother unconditionally, God says you are a liar if you say you love me. For how can you love me and you ain't never sat with me? How can you love me and you ain't never seen me? How can you love me and you ain't never had to deal with me on a personal level? Yet the walls I put in your zone, the walls I put in your face, the walls I put in your presence, you're walking around with hate and animosity. You can't love me if you can't love them. God says, well, matter of fact, the litmus test of how well you love me is graded by how well you love them.